Hello, welcome to week 6, unit 3, math and statistics libraries. In the previous unit, you have learned how to import libraries into your Python code and how to use these libraries. In this unit, we will work with a few libraries in the context of mathematics, namely the math, the random and the statistics library. And you will learn how to read the documentation and find functionality that you need inside the Python documentation. So instead of a traditional unit where I would provide some information, this unit contains just two exercises. We will switch over to the Jupyter notebooks again. I will show you the exercise then. You will try to solve the exercise yourself by reading through the documentation and trying different functionalities from these libraries. And afterwards, I, of course, will show one possible solution. So showtime. Let's switch over to our Jupyter notebook and I'll show you the first exercise. As mentioned in the introduction, you will now practice using the math, random, and the statistics library. So the first exercise is the following. Using the math library, you should write a program that performs the following tasks. First, the program should ask the user for a number. Then, the program should calculate the factorial of this number. And the program should also calculate the natural logarithm and the logarithm to base 10 for this number. And of course, the results shall be displayed to the user. In order to solve this exercise, you will need the math library and you'll need to look for suitable functions inside the math library using the documentation of the math library. So as always with exercises, I suggest you pause the video now and try to solve this exercise yourself. And remember, you have to look up in the documentation useful functions you can use to solve this exercise. Welcome back. Let's solve the first exercise together. So what do we need? We need different functions to solve this exercise. We need one function to calculate the factorial and two functions to calculate the natural logarithm and the logarithm to base 10. Let's have a look at the documentation. Probably the easiest part is to search for the terms we are looking for inside the documentation. So I will now search for the term factorial. And sure enough, there is a function called factorial. And what does this function do? The function factorial returns x factorial as an integer. It actually calculates exactly what we need. There's also a little hint here. Deprecated since version 3.9 is the possibility to accept floats. So it's not possible anymore to invoke this method factorial with a float that also has an integer value, like for example 5.0, but instead it's only possible to provide integers. So this can be used to solve the first part of the exercise. Let's do this. So what do we need? We need to ask the user first for a number. Please enter a number. And next, we of course need to convert this number into an integer again, because we want to work with integers here. And the first thing we want to calculate is a factorial. So let's call this number factorial. And we want to use the function from the math library. Therefore, of course, we need to import the math library. This is what I forgot. Import math. And I use an alias for the namespace m. And now we can use the function factorial with our number. And finally, we can print the result. print. How do we do this? Number factorial is, and then number fact. Let's give it a try. If I enter, for example, the number 6, I get the result 720. Now, it's not so nicely formatted here because we get the additional space, but that's okay. Start something else. 5 should be 120, and sure enough, it works. Okay, and now we solved the first part of the exercise. We now also need to find functions to calculate the logarithm. Again, let's do the same. Let's search for logarithm, and we find here the power and logarithmic functions. If we scroll down a little bit, we find one function that is called log. And with one argument, this function returns a natural logarithm of x. That's exactly what we need to solve the first part of the third step. And further down, we also see that there is a function which is called log 10, and this returns the base 10 logarithm. So that's the two functions we need. Here's also a little hint that actually this is the same like calling log with a second parameter, but we will lose the log 10 function instead. So let's move back to our Jupyter notebook and solve the second part of the exercise. So we need to calculate the natural logarithm. Let's call this natural log. And we can use the log function for that. And we want to have the logarithm to base 10. And we use the log 10 function for that. And also, we need to print the results. Off, and we add number here is log, and let's copy this, the logarithm base 10 logarithm of is log base 10. So this should do. Now let's give it a try. We enter the number 5 again. We know that 120 is the factorial of 5, and we get two values. Natural logarithm of 5 is 1.6, and the logarithm to base 10 is 0.69 something. Let's try another number. Let's try, for example, 100. This gives us a very large factorial, but we at least see that the logarithm to base 10 is correct, because this is a 2. Okay. That was the first exercise. And of course, this is just one possibility to solve it if you used something different. For example, if you didn't use the log 10 function here, but instead the log function with a second parameter, this is still a valid solution. So let's move to two different libraries, namely the random and the statistics library. And the exercise 2 is the following. Use functions from the random and the statistics library to first generate 100 random numbers between 1 and 10. And then you should use functions from these two libraries to calculate the mean, the median, and the variance of this list. In order to solve this exercise, you need to explore two libraries, namely the random library. As the name suggests, this library can be used to generate pseudo-random numbers. And also the statistics library. This library contains statistical functions. There you will find something like, for example, the mean to calculate the mean of some data. Again, I suggest you pause the video and try to solve this exercise yourself. Try to find suitable functions inside these two libraries. And once you have a solution, you can continue with the video and I'll show you one possible solution. So, welcome back. Let's try to solve this exercise together. So, we will again solve this exercise in small steps. So, the first thing we need to do is we need to generate a list of 100 random numbers. To do this, we have a look at the random library. There's quite some information about random numbers here. But let's scroll down a little bit, and here we find function for integers. That is what we need. There's, for example, a rand int, which returns a random integer such that a is smaller or equal to n and smaller or equal to b, so a random integer in a certain range. And we also see that that's just an alias for another function, randRange. And this is actually something we can already use. This looks like a good approach. So let's go back to here and try to create a list of 100 random numbers. In order to do this, we will need to import random. I'll import the whole library, and I also don't provide an alias. And let's just first try out how this function works. So random.randint, and we need numbers between 1 and 10. So we provide 1 and 10. Let's give this a try. We get a random number 2, random number 8. Oh, we get a 10, so it seems to work. And we also get a 1. So this random function seems to do what we need. And what we now need to create is a list of 100 random numbers. We could do this differently. We could use, for example, a for loop. What I will be using here is a list comprehension. So our random numbers is a list. And the list contains a random number for every element, I don't care, in a range of 100. So what this does, we have a range of 100, so 100 steps, and 100 times just an element from created using randint is added to the list. So in the end, we have a list of length 100 with just 100 random elements. Let's check this by printing random numbers afterwards. And of course, I have a typo here. And these are 100 random numbers. Just to make sure, we should also print the length of these random numbers, just to be sure we really created 100 random numbers, and that's the case. So here we have now solved the first part of this exercise, namely to generate 100 random numbers. The next step we need to do is we need to calculate the mean value of this list. And of course, we will look in the statistics library for this functionality. And if you read through the statistics library, pretty soon you will find here a function that's called mean. And what does mean do? Mean returns the arithmetic mean of some data, and the data can be any sequence, so also a list. And there's even an example showing us how to use this function together with a list. That's exactly what we are trying to do right now. So let's calculate the mean. We need to import the statistics library as well. Import the statistics, and that's too long. I provide an alias for this. And print the mean value of the list is. And now we can calculate the mean of our list of random numbers. Give this a try. No, there is still an error. I again have a typo. And the mean right now is 5.81. And if we as we have random numbers, whenever we execute this, we get different mean values. But they are always somehow close to 5.5, what would be the expected value. So now we also need to calculate the median and the variance of this list. Let's check again for functions. So of course, there's also a median function. The median function again works for a list, so that's nice. And now we also need to find a variance. And if we scroll down a little bit further, there is also a variance function. And the variance function also can take a list, so that's exactly what we need. Let's solve the rest of this exercise using these two functions. So I'll copy this to save a little bit typing. Median value of the list is, there's the median. And the last part is the variance. It's called median, median value, variance. And let's give this a try. And we see the median in our list is 5, and there is a variance of 7.74. And whenever I execute this, I get different values, and that's proof that we indeed work with random numbers. So again, this is just one possible solution. If you solve this exercise differently, for example, not using a list comprehension, that's still a valid solution. This is just one possibility. Let's jump back to the slides. What have you learned in this unit? You have learned about some basic libraries. You have read the documentation of these libraries yourself. You have worked with these libraries by importing these libraries and applying different functions from those libraries to solve exercises. Thanks for watching, and see you in one of the next units.